Warning, the following segment depicts highly dangerous activities. We strongly advise against the performance of any similar acts by our viewers.
Steve-O from MTV's Jackass is going to be here, and he's going to eat some goldfish or something. I don't know what he's doing. He's going to come in and do some stuff. I thought that show was off the air, Jackass.
No, it. I think the host left.
Yeah, that guy.
Right, and then they got a new guy, and they're airing new ones. That's what I think. I'm not positive.
So Steve-O is the new guy?
He's been on the whole time, I think, but maybe they made him the host. Maybe he moved up.
Yeah, because you don't want to see a good show like that go off the air.
The other dude's got like a movie career.
Hi, I'm Steve-O from Jackass, and today, instead of swallowing one goldfish, I'm going to try five.
Now, Steve, have you ever done this before?
Yeah, I did one time. I swallowed one, and I picked it up, and it lived.
Now, what goes into doing this? You just swallow them whole and...
Well, I try to drink a lot of water so that I create a safe environment for the fish in my stomach. And now we're working with a lot more fish, so...
Is there any chance you're going to vomit? Or...
Yeah, that's the only way it's going to work, yeah. I have to vomit the fish, you know.
How do fish taste?
You don't really taste them. You just kind of swallow it whole.
I'm going to introduce a guy. This guy's funny. His name's Steve-O. He's on the show Jackass. He's got a videotape he put out called Don't Try This at Home. This guy's nuts. Hey, Steve-O, what's happening, man? I was just watching your video. That is the funniest thing I've ever seen on videotape.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're good. Now, you got your start on the show Jackass. How'd you hook up with that guy, Johnny Knoxville?
We were making skateboard videos.
Yeah. Are you high, dude, or what?
Is everything all right?
I got wasted last night, man. I'm still going.
Oh, I see. He's drunk from the night before.
What'd you drink?
Just lots of beer and whiskey and wild turkey and...
That kind of stuff.
Oh, that's all?
Yeah. Where are you from?
Florida. I just moved to L.A. about a year ago.
And Johnny Knoxville went and got the host of Jackass, got a movie deal, and like gave up being a Jackass.
That's not how it worked. He deliberately started out trying to be an actor, and he was already doing movies before the show came up.
Oh. So is he like a good friend of yours?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. And he discovered you?
We both sort of got discovered by the skateboard magazine. Oh. And
because, man, you are the most hardcore, intense dude I've ever met.
How did they get into all the stupid stuff they do?
Let me tell you what this guy does. I don't know what Johnny Knoxville does, but Steve-O is insane.
Yeah.
This guy is crazy. I'm going to tell you this guy's crazy right now. He does one thing on his new video.
He looks crazy.
Yeah, he is crazy. You know, he might look crazy, but he's crazy. You're crazy,
really,
right? Have you ever been institutionalized or anything?
No, actually, I graduated from Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Clown College.
Really?
Oh, why don't you say so?
So I'm more of a circus freak.
Well, that's not crazy.
That's not crazy. Well, that's completely normal.
Really?
No, that's the craziest thing you might have done.
Darn it.
All right, listen to this.
Who even knew how you got into that?
How old are you?
27.
All right, this guy, how long have you been doing these extreme stunts?
Well, I stole a video camera from my dad when I was 15. So I guess like 12 years or so.
Do you think you're suicidal in a way?
I don't know. I'm more urging to be remembered forever, I guess.
This guy, okay?
Yeah, they've taken it a little too far.
I'll tell you some of the stuff this guy's done. One time, these dudes lit his head on fire. His hair, because now he has short hair. He had longer hair. They lit his hair on fire.
Literally.
Then, yeah. Then some dude drank like gasoline and sprayed it all over his head. Yeah. Lit his head on fire. Then he does a backflip while his head's on fire, and then he puts it out. He gets up, man. His whole face is burning off. And he's like, man, this hurts. And then they go, we better get you to a hospital. Your whole face is burnt off. I say, he does this on the tape. It's the funniest thing. Then he has this one guy throwing darts at his ass.
Yeah. Oh.
And there's all these darts and this blood gushing out of his ass. Like from the darts, his butt cheeks are bleeding.
Or how about the kid with the Roman candles at his ass?
Yes. Then this guy shot Roman candles at his ass, and one of the Roman candle things gets lodged in his ass.
That's my personal favorite.
Yeah, by the way, that rules.
Thank you.
Yeah, and then the Roman candle goes off?
Yeah, it goes off.
That's hysterical.
It's great. You got to see it.
I mean, this guy is nuts.
But these aren't stunts. Stunts aren't real.
But these are real. Then he moves his bowels. because I can't say something else. He moves his bowels in a car, moving car, and he throws it out the window at this other car. And then you get to see that.
Well, who hasn't done that?
Wait a minute.
Well,
how do you even think of that?
Who thought of that?
That was just sort of an impromptu.
Man.
My ass was ready.
That's like free associate.
Then he goes on like a skateboard or on rollerblades, and he jumps up into this car and crashes through the window, and then he pulls his pants down. His whole ass is gashed up from the window.
From the windshield?
What's your favorite stunt you ever did?
I shot up 5 ounces of vodka through an IV.
Really? What'd that do to you?
It got me pretty wasted.
Wait a second. Yeah.
You mainlined vodka?
Yeah, I think he went to the bar afterwards with like an empty bag, trying to fill it up, right?
No, I just came up with the idea. Like, I wanted to shoot up some booze, so
jeez.
I tracked down a registered nurse who was willing to give me an IV and help me empty out a bunch of the saline in the bag.
And fill
funnel
it
in 5 shots of vodka and just sort of wait it out.
That's a good nurse.
Is it different? Like, what do? You get drunk instantly?
I cursed myself for not having a breathalyzer on hand. Because what I wanted to know is, like, if you shoot up booze, can you pass a breathalyzer?
Right. That's interesting to know.
And no, I'm going to do it again, I think, just to find that out.
But, see, I would think you would pass a breathalyzer because it's not going through your mouth.
You would think so, yeah. But a lot of people tell me you know,
because it has to do with the whole content of your body. It's not just that it was in your mouth.
No. You know what I did once? I snorted Jack Daniels at a party, and it goes right to your head.
Yes.
And they said it really is an amazing feeling.
Hey, Artie, why don't you put out a video of that?
I never thought the videotape.
All the dumb crap you did.
This dude's a genius.
You know what else you do, man, that I thought was kind of funny? Or real funny. When you're on those stilts and you're on that bridge and then you jump off the bridge with the stilts, I don't know why that's funny, but it's funny. Who thought that up?
That was my idea.
Right.
My original idea was I wanted to have wooden stilts and have a midget chasing me around with a chainsaw and chop one of my stilts in half so that would make me fall off the bridge.
You know that thing where you kick that midget in the nuts? Like, did the midget, like, freak out?
He was upset, yeah.
Did he know you were going to punch him in the nuts like that?
Yeah, like, we were doing a show. We had a whole tour, like, a bunch of us getting on stage and going around and doing really dumb things. He upset me because this trick where I'm doing a handstand and he dives off his skateboard through my legs. He just rode his skateboard right into my face, and I was so upset that I told the crowd, hey, I'm going to kick Wee Man in the nuts.
Right.
So he said, go to the side, go to the side. And I didn't. I told the crowd I was going to kick him in
the
nuts.
And you did it.
You did it. You guys, there's no tricks. I mean, you're just doing these stunts.
Yeah.
They're not stunts. Stunts are fake.
Right. When you
they're burning themselves up.
Did you ever think of becoming a stuntman?
That was actually my original goal.
Yeah, dude, you're extreme. And what about when you he gets in this little tutu, like half naked, and he jumps into ice water, like an icy pond?
Extreme
ice
skating.
How much do they pay him for this?
Yeah, what do you are you making money?
I'd say like most of the way to this point has been really just exposure.
He's getting ripped off, man.
Like, what's the goal, though? I mean,
I think, like, what I've accomplished so far is really sort of figuring out what is and isn't allowed on television and deliberately filming a lot.
Yeah, the feces stuff is pretty hardcore. They don't put that on MTV, do they?
No, there's a lot of stuff that they don't put
what
on.
What won't they let you do on MTV?
Well, that's why he's got a video out. You should see the crap on there. When he cuts his ass open and, well, it's called Don't Try This at Home. It's stevovideo.com, I guess, is the only place you can get the video.
Yeah, it's
video stores won't even carry it.
Do you at least say to the kids, don't try this stuff at home? Because it's insane.
Yeah, we've got, like, you know, you have to be 18 years or older to buy it in the first place. So I think.
Yeah, but you're making a whole career out of it. Why wouldn't somebody try?
And you know how sensible 18-year-olds can be.
Yeah, but I don't think they can really sue, you know, for.
If you. I don't know.
There's been a lot of problems in the past with, you know, sort of liability as far as little kids imitating. And I just want to avoid all that and just sort of have a forum for horrible, horrible things.
I mean, what's the worst you ever hurt yourself?
Oh, man. One time, just jumping off a balcony, I did a face plant on concrete. I fractured my cheekbone. I broke 7 teeth. I had 10 stitches in my chin and a broken wrist.
And it's all been worth it?
Getting laid?
And all that for exposure?
So let me ask you something.
Huh?
So, like, MTV doesn't pay you a lot of money for being on Jackass.
Nah, they're not really known for paying a whole lot of money.
Are you getting checks from being, like, kind of famous?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. Sure, definitely. That's been the goal. Like way before I was on MTV, like all I really wanted was chicks.
Hey, Howard.
And what about like when you? Let me ask you this, because I know you do this trick where you, not a trick, but where you staple your nutsack to your leg. Like what? Like when was the first time you ever tried doing that?
When was it? It was just on this tour. Staple, like I did, used to do office stapler a lot.
Right.
And that just kind of got old and easy. And then I decided, all right, it's time for a staple gun. And then that kind of, then I said, all right, well, hey, I'm going to staple my nutsack to my leg.
And you did it.
Yeah. I actually stapled it to both legs and called it the butterfly.
Wow. and that's got to be tremendous pain.
Yeah, like one time I did it.
Weren't you afraid you could ruin your sex life? I mean, and never be able to perform?
Well, I'm not stapling my nuts.
Right, it's your nut sack.
Sack.
It's just a sack.
But
still,
do you really know where you're...
do you consult a doctor about it before you do it?
No, I've been all right with it. One time I did it, like, the staple hole has got a little bit infected.
How often can you do... like, you got to let things heal before you do it again, right?
Yeah, the nuts, I mean, I'm ready for...
Right, but I'm saying, how long do you wait between stunts? Let's say you staple your nuts today. How long do you have to wait before you can do it again?
Technically, I mean, I can do it as much as I want.
Really? And Don't they get sore?
Yeah, I would aim for a different area of the sack.
Wow.
What? You really must have a very high tolerance for pain.
I think I just have more of a distaste for work and school.
Wow, you're like awesome or something.
He's like the most awesome guy ever.
Here's some other stuff you've done. Some of this stuff I've seen you do, and some of it I haven't. You snorted a worm.
How was that?
That's got to be disgusting.
Goes right to your head.
That was
why not go on Fear Factor?
That's more gross than painful.
Would you go on Fear Factor?
What would be the point?
Yeah, why give it
50
away?
50 grand.
Yeah.
You know, I'm thinking he should go on one of those game shows like The Chamber or one of those things where they try to really physically torture you.
Here's what you did. You snorted a worm. Oh, believe me, lowering a crocodile near this guy's face would not raise his blood pressure.
The chamber, they put you in this heat chamber and they blast you with heat and fire and then they have this ice chamber.
He wouldn't care.
I don't think he could take it.
Oh,
he's still
got
to answer the question.
Trust me. Well, he might not be able to answer questions. That's
Robin,
the problem.
Robin, are you looking at him? I don't think he's going to care.
All right, he pierced his ass cheeks. Steve-O pierced his ass cheeks.
You still got that?
You waxed your whole body, which is, for a guy, that's intense. Do you got chest hair and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's nothing compared to stapling your...
He stapled his sack to his leg. He dove into a pile of elephant dung. He shot fireworks out of his butt, dressed as a urinal, and had a whole bar... go to the bathroom in the urinal.
That's gay.
Ooh. Jumped off bridges. Yeah, that is kind of gay.
Hey, what some people might think is gay, other people consider a stunt.
All right. Now, and when you were doing that thing where you were bobbing for jellyfish, did the jellyfish just sting your face?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's like, gotta hurt.
There's different species of jellyfish, so...
It wasn't that bad?
Yeah, I went for the more, like, not the man-o-war, but the moon jellies. So you got like 2 hours where you're really bummed out.
Howard, I think he ate a rat too. Is that true?
Yeah, I had like a
live rat?
No, a steamed muskrat.
Muskrat?
Why do you have goldfish here today? What are you going to do?
Well, like the first thing I ever did for MTV was I had this idea I was sitting on for like a couple of years. I'm going to swallow a goldfish and regurgitate it into a fishbowl.
Wow! So you're gonna swallow those goldfish?
I'm gonna try five of them,
and then throw them up.
You're gonna swallow the goldfish and throw them up?
Yeah, I've been over here in the green room drinking over half a gallon of water.
Yeah, he's had probably 9 or 10 bottles of water.
I don't know if I could watch this.
So the fish can swim in your stomach?
You know what? You were sitting on this idea. Why'd you do that?
I think I'd rather see you staple your nuts. Oh man!
And you think the fish are gonna be alive when they come?
Yeah, I've been working on creating a safe environment for the fish in my stomach.
Have you ever done this before?
Yeah, I did. I did with one fish before.
So just do it one. I don't want you to pass out or something.
No, I'm not going
to
pass out.
You're
Why
not?
Would you want that?
I'm not into
I'm
reruns,
afraid.
You know, like,
I'm really afraid to watch you do this.
It's well thought out, I think.
I think I can handle it. These are small fish.
It's not stapling your...
Could you defecate the fish out into an aquarium?
There's been a lot of people that told me that after seeing me do the goldfish trick that they themselves attempted it, and I have yet to hear about it going any way but out...
The
other end, yeah.
So you're going to swallow these goldfish and then throw them up.
That's my goal, yeah. I didn't come here to waste your time, man.
Did you have enough?
Steve. You did not waste our
time. Where are those fish?
They're alive, huh?
They're alive.
How many?
How many? Guy.
How many?
Shh. Here, let me get...
Steve, listen to me.
Steve, it's cool, man.
Did she do enough?
No, he's got to get the fish out.
You got three
These
fish out.
You need another bowl if you're going to
The guy just vomited out three fish.
But
three
he drank four. Five.
And nothing else.
Ugh.
When's the last time you ate?
If you just stop now, the fish will die inside of
I'll
you, right?
Another bowl.
Yeah, but he's been drinking all night. Those fish are swimming in vodka.
Yeah, the fish might get a little tipsy.
Wild turkey.
I mean, to me, you're proving that you're intense.
I don't know. That one doesn't look so good.
I did bring a...
A stapler? Oh, don't do it, man.
Get
you know
out
what, man?
Of
I'd
here.
Rather see you throw up the other two fish.
Yeah, me too.
No.
That was funny.
Oh, no. Here he goes again. He's out of water.
Yeah, I think I might be out of water.
I think you're out. You're
oh,
out.
The poor fish are dying.
Steve, you're a maniac.
Man.
Wow.
Well,
you got three fish back.
Yeah.
You got three fish back, dude.
But that was not the stunt. This was unsuccessful.
You did get a piece of another one, though.
I think it was.
What did you see?
I think one guy, like, slightly dismembered some out. Oh.
I think the head of it's right there.
Oh.
It's right there.
There's his head.
That's all about.
That was pretty impressive.
Either wow. It's blood,
you waited
one.
Too long.
Yeah, I wonder. I don't know if puking is really that good for you.
It's
no.
not.
Not like that, man.
Yeah, that was violent.
You were really. That was a hurl.
So you brought a staple gun. Tattoo. You brought a. What is that?
I think I have the dumbest tattoos.
Let me see it. I saw on your ass you've got your name here. What's that? What's it say?
I have a small wiener.
Can I show it to you?
Yeah, I saw it. I just saw it on camera.
The wiener and the tattoo.
Look at it.
That literally took me. It took me days after I got this tattoo to realize it's misspelled.
I have a small wiener, and you spelled wiener wrong.
Oh man.
The tattoo sucks. Artist didn't know that.
Yeah.
Why'd you write that on your arm?
Well, because I've got so many dumb tattoos, it's like the bar just keeps getting higher and higher. I'm thinking about my next one. I want to get a portrait of myself tattooed
on your
on
back.
Myself.
On yourself.
There's a lot of.
How do we get this video? It's steveovideo.com.
Yeah.
Damn.
Steveovideo.com.
The video's funny. The video is really good.
No, the video's great, man. It is.
Hey, Howard.
Right now, does his throat hurt from all that?
Yeah, it's gotta.
I can hear it.
Minorly, yeah.
Are you lightheaded?
Yeah, actually, yeah, totally. But that's got nothing to do.
Who's that chick? Who's that chick you brought with her? She's got to be the world's stupidest chick. Someone told me. Is that your girlfriend?
She's my babe.
Oh, is she?
You got a stupid chick. Good.
Gary was out there asking her a question. She couldn't answer one question.
Can I talk to you for a second? Can you come in here for a second? What's your name? I'm sorry.
D.
What is it?
D.
D?
D.
D, how you doing, D?
All
I
want
to ask you a couple questions. Can I ask you a couple questions? How many planets are there in our solar system?
There's Earth, Uranus, Mars, Pluto, Venus.
Go with the big one.
Jupiter. Six.
Okay.
Hi.
What does CIA stand for?
CIA?
CIA. You know, like the CIA?
Investigating
it's
terrorism. Like Men in Black.
But what does it stand for? What are the actual letters CIA?
The Center of Investigations of America.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
That was wrong.
It was close. It was pretty close.
That's all? Just two questions? Damn it.
Let's see how she does.
Get her in.
Bring her in.
Get her in here, absolutely.
Dude, you are intense.
Thank you. I'm so stoked to be here. Like,
man. Can you swallow your girlfriend, just vomit her out of you?
Will she live?
Oh, that's your girl? Wow, you're getting hot chicks.
Good God.
Look at you.
Look at her.
Has she been drinking all night, too?
I got to learn to vomit fish. Honey, you been drinking, too?
I tried to get a beer when I got here, and you didn't have any.
Oh.
We'll get you a beer, sweetheart.
You're hot. What are you, a stripper?
No.
What do you do?
I make people happy.
Ooh. You're a hooker?
There's money in that?
You're a hooker or you're an accountant. Are either one.
Are you a hooker?
I'm a free spirit.
Really?
And where do you find a free spirit? Where are you from?
You're pretty hot.
I grew up in Mississippi.
All right.
Are those real boobs?
I bought them.
Well, there's nothing wrong with it, honey. You look good. You're nice. You got a nice body, I'll tell you.
How
that.
Did you meet Steve-O there?
Man, you're lucky. You're with the coolest guy on the planet.
I met him at a show in Columbus.
Yeah. Are you ever worried he's going to hurt himself?
Mm-hmm.
You went to one of his shows where he does stuff, and you said, man, this is the guy for me?
Mm-hmm.
I got to go home with him.
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever bring home checks for him and stuff?
I made a scene of myself.
Do you ever bring home checks for him and stuff?
Not yet.
Not yet? Are you into other girls?
All the time.
I knew it.
Oh,
really?
Man.
How could you tell? What do you got, radar over there?
Oh, please. That's a party girl right there.
We were doing a show in, God, my voice is jacked now.
Yeah.
We were doing a show in Columbus, and she's showing me her boobs from the crowd. I'm like, get on stage right now.
And you've been going out with her ever since?
Yeah.
All right, let me ask you some questions. Don't help her out, Steve-O. Let's see. I want to see
how. Steve won't know.
I want to see if your chick knows anything. Not that it even matters. Not that it even matters.
No, you're fine. Okay.
How many days are in the year?
365.
That's right.
Yeah, there
kind of
you
slow,
go.
But there. You know.
I mean, it took you a while, but you got it.
She had to think about it, but she got it.
All right. Which weighs more, a pound of silicone or a pound of saline?
Silicone.
All right.
That was great.
The answer is they're both the same.
It's a
they're
pound.
They're both a pound.
Both a pound.
Okay, hold on. All right. Where is the Eiffel Tower?
Here.
Here where, though?
In
where
New
here?
York?
Where are
in
we?
In New York.
Where in New York?
In Central Park.
Okay.
That's right.
That's great.
Close enough.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. I want to go out with you
today?
After Steve-O dumps you. All right.
I think she's going to dumb me, dude.
Yeah.
Steve's the coolest guy, and she's the coolest chick.
I already asked if you were divorced.
What?
I asked if you were divorced.
She's
I
after
am.
You.
I am divorced. Hey, Steve, I can get your chick. You don't mind, man.
No.
I'll give her back to you. Don't worry. Okay. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Spell receive.
Oh, forget about it.
R-E-C-E-I-V-E.
Right.
Ooh.
Nice.
Nice comeback.
Damn, you just rebounded off the Eiffel Tower question.
I should have got her to give me my freaking I have a small wiener tattoo.
Yeah. What does KKK stand for? That's a tough one.
You're from Mississippi, right?
Yeah.
You got to know this.
KKK.
Wait a minute. She's pulling on a certain part of her anatomy to help her think.
Oh, yeah. Your boob. You're pulling on your boob,
I'll
huh?
be pulling on a certain part of my anatomy soon.
Let me pull on my anatomy while you pull on your anatomy.
Please.
I don't know.
All right.
Oh, dear.
Now, here's the next challenge. Take off your shirt and pants. She's going to do it?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, you didn't have to ask twice.
Oh, I didn't know that. I was just kidding.
Well, don't. And Steve does not.
All right, Steve, let me tell you something, man. The Steve-O video, don't try this at home. Go to steveovideo.com. Are you pissed at the Jackass guy for leaving the show and ending the show?
He didn't leave it. What's going on right now is a lot of reruns. We're in reruns, and it's just starting right now to film Jackass the movie.
Oh, okay.
Oh, cool.
So you're in that?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. You going to get some money for that?
Well, I mean,
dude, you gotta get paid, man. Come on.
By the way, those fish are still swimming around. They're doing fine.
Kill the fish.
They're all going down there to die.
They're dying. Get them out of that awful water.
No, you guys should go over after this to Central Park and see the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah. By the way, on me.
Really? Get them out of there.
Really?
They're gonna die.
It'll be fun.
How often do you get to New York? I don't know your name.
Like once a month.
Oh, this is D.
D.
Oh, D. Once a month.
Yeah.
Did you ever go to see the Eiffel Tower? You should see it.
No.
It's amazing.
It's really nice.
I've only been to Macy's.
Macy's?
Do me a favor. Go to Central Park and just say to the guy over at Tavern on the Green, where is the Eiffel Tower, and he'll direct you there. Seriously.
Yeah,
far from there, is it?
It's really a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
It's right by the Wallman Rink.
Yeah. And you know what? You can go up all the way to the top, and there's a restaurant up there.
Yeah. Right. What are you doing? Don't staple your nutsack. I'm afraid to.
You did
Come
it
on,
off,
dude.
Man. You did it off.
Come on, dude.
Come on, dude.
I'm not here to make the world a better place.
You're stapling it
I'm not here
leg?
To do stuff that's allowed on television.
How do you get the staple out after you put it in?
I'll show you, dude.
Oh. All right, we got to see that. Oh. Go ahead.
Stop, Steve.
Oh.
Right. Yeah, this is the tough part right here. Dude.
She did it without even thinking about it.
She's a good girl. Oh, he got it out. He just pulled it out.
God.
Howard, you're missing everything.
I've never seen Howard in this mood before. He's completely rattled.
It's already out.
Steve, what did you just do?
Steve, that was one of the most disturbing
Steve,
things
you're insane.
Are you bleeding? Let me see.
Oh.
You're bleeding.
The staples got blood on it.
Steve, go to a doctor and make sure.
Get some iodine.
Charlie, you're on the air.
Dude, I thought, you know, I don't know who to comment on first. I mean, Steve's great. His girlfriend's great. It's a total package.
Yeah, these guys are the next Ozzy and Harriet.
You know, it must be totally disturbing to look at, but listening on the radio is totally hysterical. I can't wait to see this on E.
Oh, you got
When are we getting this on E?
Probably never.
You got to see him vomit up these goldfish. It is. By the way, look at the goldfish.
The goldfish are dead.
I actually feel bad for the goldfish.
Look at all that vomit on top of the water.
They're in yuck.
You know what's amazing about him? Like, you think that, you know, he's on TV, so you think he must know something, and you know, he must think out these tricks. And you realize, like, the goldfish trick, he did it here for the first time. There's no thought given to any of this stuff.
What's that red crap on the top of the...
Casey thinks it might be a piece of one goldfish.
I think it might be blood, man. You got...
Nah, it's not blood.
No?
Nah.
Oh, I'm going to throw up. Just throw up in the net.
But the goldfish were being digested.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Right.
Hey, Robin, what happens? Like, can anything happen to him for having two live goldfish still in his belly?
No, they're going to be dead. There's sulfuric acid in your stomach.
And then they'll just come out on the other end.
They're going to be drunk.
They'll come out
like,
on the
yeah,
other
end. Won't even look like goldfish
Steve,
anymore.
You're going to go too far one day and end up dead. You know that.
But you know what? That'll be cool, man. You'll be all right.
You'll go
yeah,
down
cool.
and we'll do it. We'll do an incredible eulogy.
No, you go down as one of the coolest guys ever, man.
Steve, aren't you afraid?
Hey, man, everybody's going to be dead, dude.
But
Steve, where are you going to go from here? I mean, you've done it all.
Like, can you see yourself at 40? What are you going to be doing?
Let's see what happens with this Jackass movie.
Okay.
I have not done it all.
I got. What are you doing in the Jackass movie, by the way?
They got a top.
What could you be doing?
I'll say one idea I have. It's called the Vasectomy Olympics.
What's that?
Go ahead.
Just deliberately get a vasectomy and then run through an obstacle course and do the rope swings and, you know.
Oh, you know what he's talking about?
Lap dances from strippers.
When
too,
you get a vasectomy, I know somebody who had it done. Your testicles get to like the size of a grapefruit.
Yeah.
So the second that they're all in pain, he's going to go like move them around and do stuff.
It's like, I think it's notorious for like the most uncomfortable position a man can be
Steve,
in.
Right, you're not supposed to
ride
really
a horse.
Exert yourself.
Mike, you're on the air.
Yo, Howard, I love this dude, Steve-O, man. Check it out. Is there anything else in the studio he could eat? Like, that Dostoevsky or something?
Oh, come on. Get out of here. That's obscene. That's just horrible.
That was a scumbag.
That's not the right thing.
That's obscene.
How fast did D just staple his sack, though? It was like not even an issue.
Hey, D,
just,
what's your story?
Here, honey.
Don't you love those?
My God.
Aren't you in love with him?
Uh-huh.
You are.
Mm.
You love him.
Mm.
They're sort of like Sid and Nancy, but they haven't killed anyone yet.
Right.
Yeah. Just each other. Yet.
You guys should go to the top of the Eiffel Tower, and Stevie should propose to her. It's romantic.
Today
in Central Park. Go to the Eiffel Tower.
Mike, you're on the air.
Do you remember years back the guy you were going to mace Howard?
Yeah.
And then the guy, Johnny Knoxville, wrote a letter in?
Yeah.
So basically you were going to do that first.
Right.
And then how about the crapping out the window? Didn't Jackie do that? And how about shoving stuff up the nose? Didn't the guy do that on your CBS show?
Hey, listen, this kid's hardcore. I don't know what your point is.
I think you stapled your nuts, and they're stealing that, too.
Oh, get out of here. Steve-O, you're awesome.
This kid perfected it, man.
Hey, if you really want to do a stunt that's super dangerous, get married. All right.
No, that's just really painful.
You wouldn't do that, would you?
Talk about stapling your nuts.
Jamie, you're on the air.
You never pull that staple out.
Yeah, Howard, what's up? Listen, I just want to know this guy's girlfriend. She's attracted to some real talent, huh?
Oh, well, jealous?
Listen, what was her last boyfriend, a juggling monkey?
Are you jealous of this guy? You're saying he's talentless. I'm saying he's got some sort of ability here.
Well, he's got goals.
But listen, I just want to know, like, at what point of his life did he realize he had, like, absolutely nothing going on for himself, that he had to staple his nutbags to his legs?
This kid was accepted into Harvard. He got a perfect 1600 on his SATs, and he threw it all away for this, okay?
I'm sure his girlfriend did, too.
How'd you do on your SATs, though? Were you, like, a student at all?
Take the SATs?
1190.
Really?
Yeah. Stop.
Beat my ass.
No kidding.
Wait a second. You saying you did the same?
Me?
Yeah.
I had an ACT scholarship to college.
What does that mean?
I graduated with honors.
From where?
What?
Mississippi.
The whole state?
Yeah.
No, where Mississippi did you graduate
Carthage.
From?
Carthage.
That's a college?
Right.
No, it's high school.
No, she's very smart.
Hey, don't pick on my babe. Okay?
Exactly, she's man. Cool. You know what, honey? Great. You got great boobs and a beautiful ass, and I love your panties and everything.
Yeah, you're beautiful.
I could care less.
Before she met Steve-O, she could answer all of those.
Do your parents approve of what you're doing, Steve-O?
They'd like you to see to get paid for
like,
it.
Yeah, they're... My dad actually helps me negotiate my contracts and stuff. Like,
what's he do? Is he a lawyer?
Well, I guess he's just
a gardener.
Yeah.
No, what does he do?
Yeah. He doesn't sound like Michael.
Let's just say he's proud.
All right.
And he's glad that I'm not at home anymore.
Do you have your own house now, or you have roommates?
I've got an apartment in L.A.
Own place, or you got a...
Your rent?
Yeah, actually, my roommate.
Oh, you got a roommate.
Yeah. Male stripper.
You're not doing very well.
You ought to get your dad to stop negotiating for you, but you should be making some money with all the crap you do.
Really, man? Get an agent.
You're risking your life.
Yeah, really. What
Johnny Knoxville's probably got an estate at this point.
What does your dad do for a living when he's not negotiating for you?
I guess like he had a little consulting thing going on. I don't know.
Consulting who?
Him.
About what?
Off my back, dude.
Johnny Knoxville's getting tons of dough.
Steve? Is he?
Yeah.
Steve, it's your dad. We worked out the contract for stapling your nuts. You'll be getting $80.
Wow.
Anyway, the two of you are crazy. It's great. Steve-O Video. Go to steveovideo.com. You can get this video where Steve does, among other things, staple his nuts, has darts thrown at his ass.
It's pretty great.
Do you vomit anything?
Now, like, not only when you go to steveovideo.com do you get the Don't Try This at Home video, you also get the career ender.
Which is
a video of, like, such horrible things that I literally called it the career ender. It's, like, deliberately geared to just be so horrible that industry professionals claim I'll never work again.
How soon can I get a video of D is what I want to know.
Yeah. Hey, D, do you do any porno or anything?
D has some spots.
Really?
Oh, D, you do any hardcore porno?
He has it.
She's more of a stunt woman.
Oh, really?
I can't believe how jacked my throat is after that puke set.
Yeah, dude, you need to go chill. All right, we're going to take a break. Fred Durst should be here. Is he here?
I haven't got the check.
All right.
Will he staple his nuts to it?
I wouldn't want to be Fred Durst.
Hey,
I wouldn't want to follow this kid.
Steve, you play guitar at all?
No.
Yeah.
All I ever wanted to do is just be a dumb ass.
Congratulations. Well, you made it.
Dude, you're the king of the dumb asses.
You have made it.
These are two of my favorite people in the whole world, right?
Yeah.
Right.
People reach their goals.
Do you do any weird stuff?
No.
Dee, do you do any weird stuff?
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah, nothing we could see, huh? All right, listen, we're going to take a break. I'd come over and shake your hand, but I don't want to touch your hand if you vomited.
Yeah, you stuck it down your throat.
But thanks, guys.
So, dude, how do you feel?
My throat's a little jacked from puking.
So, wait, how many came out?
Two.
Two came out. So three more are still in your stomach.
Yeah.
Oh, dude. How do you nuts?
My nuts, actually, like, that one actually kind of hurt my nuts a little bit. Normally it hurts my leg more than my nutsack, but my nuts actually hurt right now.
So what are you going to do? What do you have to do now? You're bleeding, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm going to just go clean up in the bathroom real quick.
How you doing, brother?
Doing sweet, man.
Sounded pretty good.
Yeah, I don't even know what I'm doing here. This is crazy. I'm just a dumb dude.
All right. I think we can get our jackets.
So you need to clean up here?
Yeah, totally. See how my nutsack is doing. Oh, yeah, dude. Check it out.
Does it hurt?
Can you show nutsacks on TV?
No.
As long as I keep the wiener out of it?
No, you can't.
Man.
Dude, do you have to like clean that up or put something on it?
I'm gonna go ahead and just not worry about it.
Just hope it goes away.
Yep. Man, this is nuts. Dude, I can't believe everyone was so nice to me. You'd think they'd pick on me for being such an idiot.
Hey, you were great.
Dude. Crucial to pee. Dude, now, do normal, like, people come on this show, like, actually sleep before they come on, or...?
Yeah, usually.
Wow.
That I refuse to believe. Because, I mean, I wouldn't know how to wake up. I literally just, I was like, man, dude, we need to get more booze. I'm never going to make it.
Benji here wants you to staple his nuts to the wall.
What?
Benji wants you to staple his nuts to the wall.
That's funny.
Are you peeing out fish?
Yeah.
Dude, how long is this piss taking?
Well, dude, I drank like over half a gallon of water. God, I'm bummed out to find out that that's bad for fish. That sucks.